So now we'll discuss about the limitations, okay, of the octet rule. So we have seen just now, okay, that there is a sharing and there is a pairing of the electron that takes place, okay, between the different atoms in a molecule. So while making the pair, so we have focused over the octet rule, that it must complete the octet. बराबर है, अभी हमने हम लोगों ने ये देखा कि वो octet complete करना चाहिए, okay? But there are some molecules which are not completing their octet, okay, but still their stability is good, they are stable molecules, okay, so they are not even completed their octet, there may be more than 8 electrons are present, okay, so that is the limitations of the octet rule, okay, so octet rule does not explain the stability of some molecule, okay, so this is very important. So what is the first limitation? That this does not explain the stability of some molecule, okay, so stability of some molecule. So there are some molecules which are not completing their octet, but still they are stable. So that's why this is not the only way, or this is not the only one parameter, like completing octet means it is a stable, okay. So there are some other elements too which are having lesser number of the electrons than the octet, or having higher number of electrons than the octet, but still they are stable. So this is not a deciding factor, octet is not a deciding factor for the stability. So this is, I think we have already discussed about this also, okay. There are other factors like how much amount of energy is also factor, okay, how much amount of energy is released, okay, that is being the factor also. Then the octet rule is based on the inert behavior of the noble gas, okay, because generally what we are doing, we are completing the octet. What it means, it is acquiring a noble gas configuration. Barabar kya ho raha hai, generally noble gas configuration attained ho raha hai, it is having NS2 and NP6, okay, such kind of a configuration it is acquiring, okay, may not be possible for all the atoms, okay, may not possible for the all atoms, okay. So it is very useful to explain the structure and the stability of the organic molecules. So however, there are many molecules whose existence cannot be explained by the octet theory. Just now I said that there are some other elements also, those are having lesser number of electrons and higher number of electrons than the octet, but still they are stable. So this is not only the deciding factor, that completing its octet, completing the noble gas configuration is a deciding factor about the stability. There are more other factors too that are responsible for the stability of any molecules, okay. So the examples are the center. So however, there are many molecules whose existence can be explained by the octet theory. The central atom in these molecules does not have 8 electrons in their valence shell, okay, and yet they are stable. So examples of such molecules which are not having the 8 number or octet complete, but still they are stable, okay. So examples are BeCl2, okay, BeCl2, that is PF5U, okay, these are stable molecules, although octet is not complete, their octet is we can say not complete, ya fir zyada bhi ho sakta hai, okay, octet is not complete, okay, jinka octet complete nahi hai, aisa ho sakta hai ki zyada bhi number of electrons isme reh sakte hain, okay, ya kam bhi reh sakte hain, but their octet but still they are stable molecules, okay. So this is the example. Then such molecules can be categorized as having incomplete octet, okay, having incomplete octet, then expanded octet, or odd electrons. So it can be categorized into like this, it is categorized into incomplete octet, okay. What is that? Incomplete octet, jinka octet complete nahi hai, okay. Then it can be expanded octet, okay. Next one is a expanded octet, okay, expanded octet, and a more number of the elements are present and the odd electrons, okay. And the third one is electrons. So based on these three concepts. One is the incomplete octet. Okay, what is the meaning of incomplete octet? The molecules with incomplete octet, examples. Okay, the examples of these are this BF3. Okay, BF3, then BeCl2, BeCl2 and LiCl. Okay, LiCl. So in these, the covalent molecules, the central atom here B, this Be, okay, and this lithium is not complete incomplete octet. So if you consider the number of valence electron for the boron is 3. Okay, 3 valence electrons say dekho 1, 2 and suppose this is 3. Okay, chalo agar maan lo ye dekho fluorine atom hai. Okay, fluorine atom. So fluorine is having total 7 number of electrons. Okay, ye dekho yahan pe. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. Okay, then this fluorine atom 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Another this fluorine atom. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So it will have this single bond and single bond. So although its octet is complete, ये देखो, इसका भी octet complete हो रहा है, इसका भी octet complete हो रहा है. But if you are checking value for boron, boron की अगर octet अगर देखोगे, तो ये octet नहीं complete कर रहा है. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay. So boron अगर मैं आप देखोगे तो इट इज हैविंग ओनली 6 नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स इन इट्स पेयरिंग मींस व्हाट इट इज इनकम्प्लीट ऑक्टेट बराबर है इसका ऑक्टेट क्या है इनकम्प्लीट है ओके अनदर एग्जांपल इफ वी आर लुकिंग फॉर द BeCl2 ओके BeCl2 के लिए अगर देखते हैं हम लोग ओके सो BeCl2 चलो बेरिलियम ओके सो हैविंग 2 वैलेंस इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ओके बेरिलियम इज हैविंग 2 valence electrons, okay, chalo, 2 valence electrons, Be and Cl, chlorine is having 7, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, okay, here chlorine, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7, so what will happen, this will get paired with this beryllium, and this will get paired, and it will complete its octet, and it will complete its octet, what about beryllium, beryllium is still having only 4 number of electrons in a pair, barabari, 1, 2, and 3, 4 means it is incomplete octet it is what incomplete octet aap dekh sakte ho it is incomplete octet right now okay another example if we are taking okay like LiCl okay LiCl so yes LiCl okay lithium and this chlorine okay so chlorine is having 7 number of valence electrons like this okay so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 and this lithium valence electron is 1 So what is happening here? This will get bond and it will complete its octet. What about lithium? What about lithium? It is having only 2 electrons. Okay, it is having only 2 electrons. It has not completed its octet. Okay, so in this way, so these are what called as an incomplete octet. It is not completing the octet. Okay, it is not completing the octet. So these are the examples. Okay. So, but they are stable. But all these atoms, all these molecules are a stable molecule. All these molecules are a stable molecules. Okay. So they have less than 8 electrons in their valence shell, but are stable. This okay. So this is boron in this BF3, and this beryllium in this BeCl2, and this lithium in this LiCl. Molecules are having less number of electrons okay but they are stable okay they are stable electrons okay then next is molecule with expanded octet okay what is the next concept okay molecule with expanded octet and jisme number of jo electrons hai wo zyada hai okay it is more than the octet so see what are that and their structure so second type okay second type in this okay in this the is molecule with expanded octet okay molecule with expanded okay expanded octet what is the meaning of this molecule with expanded octet it means the total number of valence the total number of electrons okay sharing electrons okay are forming the pair electrons If you will observe It is more than octet. Okay, okay. It is more than 8 in this case. So examples are SF6. Okay, SF6. Then PCl5. Okay, PCl5. Then next is H2SO4. Then next is H2SO4. So these are some examples. Okay. So if you see, sulfur is having 6 valence electrons. Okay, sulfur may 6 valence electrons. So in case of this sulfur, 6 valence electrons. So here 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6. 6 valence electrons. Okay, so these are 6 valence electrons for the sulfur, and which are attached with the fluorine. And you know very well, for the fluorine atom, it is having already the 7 number of valence electrons. So 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, 5, 6, and this one is a 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. In the same way, so this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. And this fluorine atom, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. In this way, this is the structure. Okay. So although this fluorine atom is completing its octet, yes, it is pairing with one of the electron from the sulfur. But if you will check for a sulfur, sulfur ke liye aap check karoge, so you will observe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Okay. So it is having around 12 number of electrons. So in this SF6, 12 electrons around a sulfur. So you are observing 12 electrons, that is around sulfur. Sulfur ke around me aap dekho, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 electrons are present. It is not completing its octet. It is more than the octet. So molecule with expanded octet, but still it is a stable. Molecule. Another example being PCl5. So yes, phosphorus is having 5 number of valence electrons. Okay, so phosphorus is having 5 number of electrons. So 1, 2, 3, and suppose this 4 and 5. Okay, chlorine is having 7 number of valence electrons. So dekho yahan pe chlorine 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. This is chlorine 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and 7. So yes, whenever it is pairing with one of the electron, okay, yeah, yahan pe rahega chlorine 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So whenever it is pairing with one of the chlorine, one of the phosphorus electron, so dekho chlorine to octet iska complete kar raha hai, but if you will check for a phosphorus, phosphorus ke liye check karoge aap log 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So this 10 electrons, okay, that is around phosphorus. Phosphorus ke around mein kitne electrons hai? Total 10 electrons. But still it is stable. Okay, still it is a stable. So that's the reason that the stability cannot be explained only by the octet. Okay, it cannot be explained with the help of the octet. Okay. Then if you will see next H2SO4. So in case of this H2SO4 structure, okay, so this will be sulfur. Okay, beech mein rahega, it is having double bond with oxygen. Okay, oxygen ke saath isme 1, 2, 3, 4, and this 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5, 6. H2SO4. Okay, so O4. So this here it is oxygen. Okay, double 2, and here it is a H. Okay. Here it is oxygen and it is bonded with the H. So now look at this right now. Okay, yes, hydrogen is completing its duplet because hydrogen completed its duplet. Barabar hai, hydrogen iska duplet complete kar raha hai. Oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and all these oxygens, they are completing their octet. Aap check kar sakte ho 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, here also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Means all oxygen and hydrogen, they are completing their octet and duplet respectively. For hydrogen, it is completing its duplet. For oxygen, all oxygens are completing their octet. But if you are checking for a sulfur, that is a central atom, so you will observe that 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 electrons okay, 12 electrons are around, okay, 12 electrons that are present around sulfur, okay, around a sulfur, but still it is a stable molecule, still this molecule is a stable. So that is what the stability, okay, it is that does not explain, okay, stability, octet rule is not explaining the stability of the molecule, okay. So there are some molecules in which, okay, so this is about the molecules with the expanded octet, okay. So it must be remembered that the sulfur also forms many compounds in which the octet rule is obeyed, okay. So aisa nahi hai ki sab mein ye possible hoga. There are some molecules in which this sulfur will form the octet. Octet form hoga, there are many, okay. So aap book mein bhi dekh sakte ho. So in this way, so like this, suppose, okay, SCl2, okay. So this SCl2, so sulfur 1, 2, okay, 3, 4, okay, 5, and this is the 6, and it is forming, okay, a bond, single bond with the chlorine, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this is chlorine, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7. So look at this right now, sulfur, okay, total valence electron is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, okay, and yes, it is completing its octet. Aap dekh sakte ho, it is completing its octet, and it is completing its octet. And if you check for the sulfur, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, sulfur is also completing its octet. Means we cannot say that, okay, that sulfur, okay, is having always expanded octet. Aisa kuch nahi hai. Okay, there are other molecules also in which the sulfur is completing its octet. Okay. So this is about the molecules with the expanded octet. Another is the odd electron molecule. Okay, odd electron molecule. So we'll see odd electron molecule. What is that? Odd electron molecule. So another third, that is odd electron molecule. Okay, third is what? Odd electron molecules. Odd electron molecules. So what is this odd electron molecules? Okay, some molecules like this, suppose NO, nitric oxide. Okay, if you consider the example of this nitric oxide. Okay, nitric oxide ka agar hum log example lete hai. So this nitric oxide and this NO2, that is nitrogen dioxide, okay, nitrogen dioxide, this nitrogen oxide, nitrogen dioxide, NO2, these do not obey the octet rule, okay. Both nitrogen and oxygen atoms have odd number of electrons. So if you check nitrogen is having 5 valence electrons, okay. So yahan pe dekh sakte ho, 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is 5 electrons. Oxygen is having, yes, 6, 1, 1, 2, okay, 3, 4, and this is suppose 5, 6. So it is having, it is bonding, it is having a double bond with each other. If you will check the octet for the nitrogen, it is not completing its octet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, total 7 number of electrons are present, okay, around the nitrogen, and around the oxygen, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay, it is completing its octet, okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Another example of this NO2, okay, NO2, agar aap log check karoge isme, so this oxygen, 1, 2, then 3, 4, then here it is forming a double bond, okay, 6 electrons for the nitrogen, ye dekho nitrogen yahan pe hai, okay, then here 1, here having 1 electron, then this oxygen, okay, oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, okay, and 5, 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 more extra, which is taken from this nitrogen, and that's why it is having a minus charge and it is having a plus charge, 1, 2, 3, 4, okay. So in this way it is completing this single bond, okay, or yahan pe jo hai nitrogen mein, okay, yes, इट इज कंप्लीटिंग 1, 2, 3 and 4 यहाँ पे होने चाहिए. एंड इन दिस वे इफ यू विल ऑब्जर्व राइट नाउ, ओके, नाइट्रोजन 1, 2, 3, 4 एक्चुअली 5 इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट इन नाइट्रोजन एट इट्स बैलेंस, बट एक इलेक्ट्रॉन्स यहाँ पे दे दिया एंड इट इज हैविंग अ माइनस चार्ज राइट नाउ ओवर दिस ऑक्सीजन, ओके, और इसमें उसके ऊपर प्लस चार्ज आ गया. 1, 2, 3, 4 फोर इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर राइट नाउ प्रेजेंट ओके अराउंड द नाइट्रोजन. So it will check 4 electrons for the nitrogen, okay, oxygen 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 for this oxygen, and for this oxygen 1, 2, okay, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, okay. So here the odd electrons molecules are present, odd electron molecule is present, aap dekh sakte ho, yahan pe 7 electrons are present in nitrogen, here 4 electrons are present around the nitrogen, okay. So such kind of a case in which they do not obey the octet rule, both nitrogen and oxygen atoms have odd number of the electrons, okay, like this are the examples, okay. So the observed shape and geometry of a molecule cannot be explained by the octet rule, okay. Another limitations, the second limitation of this octet rule is that the observed shape and geometry, okay, so the shape, observed shape, or we can say geometry, okay, geometry of the molecule, okay, of a molecule cannot be explained by the octet rule, okay. Geometry of a molecule, okay, it cannot be explained, it cannot be explained by octet rule. So this is another limitation, octet rule se hum log ये नहीं कर सकते. जैसे फर्स्ट लिमिटेशन था दैट डज नॉट एक्सप्लेन द स्टेबिलिटी ऑफ सम मॉलिक्यूल्स, ओके, सो देर आर सम अदर मॉलिक्यूल्स, ओके, देर आर सम मॉलिक्यूल्स इन विच द आइदर मे बी लार्ज नंबर ऑफ द इलेक्ट्रॉन्स अराउंड दैट एटम, देर मे बी लेस नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर प्रेजेंट अराउंड दैट एटम एंड देर मे बी ऑड नंबर ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स ऑल्सो मे बी प्रेजेंट ओके अराउंड दैट एटम. जस्ट नाउ वी हैव सीन ऑल दिस थ्री केसेस, सो दीज आर द लिमिटेशंस ऑफ दिस ऑक्टेट रूल, वेरी फर्स्ट. एंड सेकंड वन इज वॉट, if you check about the observed shape and the geometry of the molecule, we cannot get the geometry or its shape, okay, from the octet. Octet rule is telling you anything about the geometry or the shape? No, it is not telling us anything about the shape as well as the geometry of that molecule. Uska structure kaisa hai, okay, uska shape kaisa hai us molecule ka, ye hame nahi batata hai octet rule, okay. So this is the second limitations, and the third is octet rule fails to explain the difference in energies of the molecule, okay. So this octet rule, it fails to explain energies of a molecule, explain energies of the molecule, energies of a molecule ke bare mein hame ye nahi batata hai octet rule. So it fails to explain energies of the explain the difference in energies, okay, so explain difference, we can say difference in energies, okay, difference in energies of the molecule. And though all the covalent bonds are formed in an identical manner, that is by sharing a pair of electrons, the rule fails to explain the difference in reactivities of different molecule, okay. So what is the, it fails to explain about the difference in the reactivity of a different molecule, difference in reactivity of different molecule, okay, different molecule, because octet rules hum log ye nahi predict kar sakte that it is forming the octet means yes it is a more reactive or it is a less reactive. So these are the limitations of the octet rule, very first being does not explain about the stability, okay, second is it cannot explain about the shape and the geometry of the molecule, and the third is it fails to explain about the difference in the energies of the molecule. Agar do molecule lete hain hum log, okay, ye dekho suppose NO and dusra NO2, it cannot tell us about, means octet complete kar raha hai yani uski energy zyada hai, octet nahi complete kar raha hai yani uski energy kam hai, we cannot predict this, okay. This is the limitation, and the last is what about the difference in the reactivity of the different molecules, okay. So how this molecule will react, this cannot be explained with the help of the octet rule. Wo octet complete kar raha hai yani wo zyada reactive hai, और जो नहीं कर रहा है वो कम रिएक्टिव है. इन दिस वे वी कैनॉट प्रेडिक्ट. ओके वी दिस कैनॉट बी प्रेडिक्ट. ओके देयर रिएक्टिविटी कैनॉट बी प्रेडिक्ट बेस्ड ऑन दी ऑक्टेट रूल. सो दीज आर दी लिमिटेशंस ऑफ दी ऑक्टेट रूल.